Respected Tiwari sir, friends, good afternoon to all of you. The topic of my seminar is not even chosen with myself because I am from mathematics subject. We take a very simple mathematics, very simple mathematics. All of you know about basic algebra, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Product of two non-zero numbers, if we multiply two non-zero numbers, then it never gives zero. But in my research, we found a number which is called bicomplex numbers, and in this number we select two trivial numbers. After multiplying these, we will get zero. So, objective of my study is to find two non-zero numbers whose product is zero. All of you know about real numbers. First, we start from real numbers. All of you know about real numbers, numbers used in daily life. First, we define real numbers. What is real numbers? Numbers used in daily life, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so forth, so on, all of the numbers are real number. And when we get two non-zero real numbers, for example, you take 2 and 4, multiplying 2 into 4 equal to 8, not 0. The definition of real number in mathematical definition is this: a real number is a value of a continuous quantity that can be represented a distance along a line. This is the representation of real number along a line. These number are one dimensional number. Real numbers are one dimensional. We can represent real number on one dimensional, on a straight line. Note here, multiplication of two non-zero real numbers is never zero. All of you satisfy that multiplication of two non-zero real numbers is never zero. Then we reach up to complex numbers. This is also a very interesting number, complex number. If we ask what is the value of root 9, everyone know what is the value of square root of 9, it is plus minus 3. But what is the value of square root of minus 9? It gives when we solve the equation x square plus 9 equal to 0. If anyone asks what is the solution of the equation x square plus 9 equal to 0, if you are given to find the solution of x square minus 9 equal to 0, then x square equal to 9 and you get x equal to plus minus 3. But when you are given to find the solution of the equation x square plus 9 equal to 0, then x square equal to minus 9 and hence x equal to root minus 9. What is the value of root minus 9? So solution is this: root 9, we express here root minus 9 is equal to root minus 9 into 1. And this equal to plus minus 3, square root of 9 is plus minus 3 and under root minus 1. And this under root minus 1 is denoted by a special letter I, which is called iota. So I is the root minus 1 and hence I square equal to minus 1. Thus root minus 9 can be expressed as 0 plus minus 3i. This expression as 0 plus minus 3i, this form is called a complex number. This gives a motivation to know what is a complex number. So we generalize the complex number in the next slide. In general, a complex number can be expressed in the form z equal to x plus y. In the example 0 plus minus 3i, x is 0 and y is 3. where x is the real part of the complex number z and y is the imaginary part of z. A representation of complex number you see in this figure. On real axis, we take x unit on real axis and y unit on imaginary axis. So intersecting them, you will get z. Z is there, z equal to x plus iy. This is the representation of complex number. If you take z equal to 2 plus 3i, so plot 2 on real axis, 3 on y axis, so you will get z equal to 2 plus 3i. This is the structure in two dimensions. So complex numbers are two dimensional. You know that complex number, when we multiply two complex number, it also gives never zero. Multiplication of two non-zero complex numbers is never zero. So we reach next number. It is given to bicomplex number. The representation of bicomplex number is similar as complex number. We denote definition. A bicomplex number is defined is this letter. It is called zeta. So zeta equal to z1 plus I2 z2. Complex number is denoted by z equal to x plus iy. X is real part of z, y is imaginary part of z. Zeta is also defined in the same frame, z1 plus I2 z2. But here z1 and z2 both are complex number. In the case of complex number, z equal to x plus iy, x is real and y is real. But in the case of bicomplex number, z1 and z2 both are complex number. This is the representation of bicomplex number in terms of complex number, zeta equal to z1 plus I2 z2, where z1 and z2 both are complex numbers. And we define complex bicomplex number in terms of real number here. Zeta equal to, in the place of z1, we put x1 plus I1 x2. This is complex number. And in the place of z2, we put x3 plus I1 x4. So after solving this, you get zeta equal to x1 plus I1 x2 plus I2 x3 plus I1 I2 x4. So this is the definition of a bicomplex number in terms of real coefficient, real numbers, where x1, x2, x3, x4 all are real numbers. This number zeta is four dimensional number. This is a four dimensional number. We cannot represent in the space because of it is four dimensional. Property of I1, I2. What is the property of I1, I2? In the case of complex number, z equal to x plus iy, I square equal to minus 1. Here also, I1 square equal to minus 1, I2 square equal to minus 1, and relation in I1 and I2, I1 into I2 equal to I2 into I1. So it gives the commutative law, means A into B equal to B into A. Zero in bicomplex number defined, 0 is equal to 0 plus I1, 0 plus I2, 0 plus I1, I2, 0. It is a 0. And unity is 1 equal to 1 plus I1, 0 plus I2, 0 plus I1, I2, 0. Bicomplex numbers are four dimensional. Now, we see these two special numbers. Property, E1 and E2 are also bicomplex number because here I2 is here. E1 and E2 both are bicomplex numbers having the property E1 square equal to E1, E2 square equal to E2, and E1 into E2 equal to 0. E1 square equal to E1 and E2 square equal to E2, it gives the idempotent elements. It means the elements are idempotent. So it is called idempotent elements in the set of bicomplex numbers. The second property is E1 into E2 equal to 0. This is, you see here how E1 into E2 equal to 0. This is the main thing, E1 dot E2 equal to 0. These two bicomplex numbers are not 0. E1 is non-zero and E2 is non-zero. When we multiplied, we get 0. How? You see the solution, verification of this, E1 dot E2 equal to 0. E1 is this 1 plus I1 I2 by 2 and E2 is 1 minus I1 I2 by 2. After solving this, denominator is 4. And you see the formula A square minus B square, very simple formula, classic 7 level, A square minus B square equal to A plus B, A minus B. So in the first bracket 1 plus I1 I2, in second bracket 1 minus I1 I2. Using the formula, you get 1 square minus I1 I2 square. 1 square is 1, next I1 square, I2 square, I1 square is minus 1, I2 square is minus 1, as you see in the previous slide. So after solving, you will get 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1 is equal to 0, multiply 1 by 4, you will get 0. So we have two non-zero numbers E1 and E2. When we multiply these two numbers, we will get 0. This is the my topic, that we find two non-zero numbers whose product is 0. But anyone say what is the interest? You see here. Second definition, bicomplex number ki dekhiye. Bicomplex number can also expressed in the form of idempotent elements. Z1 plus I2 Z2 can be expressed in this form. Z1 minus I1 Z2 E1 plus Z1 plus I1 Z2 E2. If we take two bicomplex number, Z1 plus I2 Z2 and W1 plus I2 W2. In the form of idempotent components, if we multiply, multiplication is very simple. When you multiply these bicomplex number, you will get 16 terms. Because of in one bicomplex number, there are 4 terms, and another bicomplex number, there are 4 terms. When we multiply it, we get 16 terms. But properties of E1 and E2 is, Z1 plus I2 Z2, one bicomplex number, W1 plus I2 W2, another bicomplex number. We write these two bicomplex number in terms of idempotent components as there. After multiplying, you will get first coefficient into second coefficient E1 plus first coefficient Z1 plus I1 Z2 and second coefficient W1 plus I1 W2 and E2. This is very simple multiplication. Nth power, power of any number. If you are given to power of a number, Z1 plus I2 Z2 to power n is defined Z1 minus I1 Z2 power n E1 plus Z1 plus I1 Z2 power n E2. Very simple. Multiplication, division. Division is also very, very simple. So thus we have two non-zero bicomplex number E1 and E2 whose multiplication is 0. So these are two bicomplex number. When we multiplied, you will get 0. Thank you. Yes.